Hello, welcome to Mansalona Broadcasting here on our YouTube channel. I'm Brendan Morris, your host. Good morning. Thanks for tuning in for this evening and today's wrestling match. Mansalona Invitational. And they host a variety of teams from Kalkaska, Forestieria, Boyne City, and Lake City. There's about a total of 10 teams invited. But only those teams I mentioned, as well as Mansalona, are here today. This will be an all-day event. Wrestling is underway right now, sort of about 10 o'clock. And it should go till about 2 or 3. We'll have some breaks in between. We'll cover the Mansalona rounds. Yes, we do have a fellow Mansalona wrestler who is actually on a different team going to wrestle for Forestieria. It's Hayden Wagonshoots. Forestieria doesn't have a very large team. Not quite sure on the rules there, but he's able to wrestle for the Warriors and get points for them. And individually, he can wrestle. And obviously get a win for himself. Got picked up his first win of the season the other night. Hoping to continue the winning streak here. First time wrestler, so obviously trying to get a hang of it. Still new to the sport and never easy. Starting out wrestling the first few years, definitely a demanding sport. He'll face Kalkaska here. So the Ironmen, for the most part, not wrestling. They're relaxing on the bleachers right now, and they're awaiting their round two match against Kalkaska. Colin Ritchie Blue and Harrison Morgan hoping for a good match. So here's Wagonshoots tied up with Kalkaska, trying to earn his second win, make this one count. Kalkaska definitely has the numbers for a solid team. And Wagonshoots brought down on his back, trying to roll out of it. Stuck right now. Good move by Wagonshoots to get out of it. But right back in the down position. Kalkaska trying to rip down on that arm. Get a lock on that arm and trying to put him on his back. Wagonshoots trying to stand up. Don't want to go on the back or get caught in that cradle. And that is a pin. Kalkaska pins Wagonshoots in the 42nd second of the first round. So, nice job by Wagonshoots, but the Blazers got the better of him there, so he'll be able to rest. And Mansalona will be up shortly. So once again, thank you for tuning in. I'm Brendan Morris. We'll be right back with the coverage of Mansalona and Kalkaska right after these two matches. And thank you. Hello, welcome back to Mansalona Broadcasting. I'm your host, Brendan Morris. Today's Mansalona Invitational Meet has been underway. First four set of teams are beginning to end their match. Kalkaska and Forestieri just got over, and Kalkaska won that one handily. 48-24 against a undersized Forestieri team. Not necessarily undersized, but number-wise, do not have a whole lot of guys, so it's obviously near impossible to win as a team, but individual has some good success. Kalkaska, a large team, and bound to have plenty of success, plenty of solid wrestlers. And the Blazers win the first match, but guess what? They'll have to take on the home team. That's Mansalona. The Ironmen have had their ups and downs this season, but overall definitely a well-bonded team, according to John Holman, first-year wrestler and junior, one of the big guys on this team. Holman wrestling at 242 today. But overall, this team definitely has had its up and downs. It is definitely capable of having a winning season as a team. And of course, you get into those times where you face even larger schools like Traverse City and schools of that nature who just always have the numbers. And sometimes Mansalona struggles to have the numbers. But then again, they have a lot of young guys, a lot of new faces on this team. Trying to revamp this program to what it was a few years ago. Colin Ritchie Blue and Harris Morgan have done a fantastic job of coming in here the past two seasons now and revamping this program. And now, like I said, a lot of young faces could create some ability for success in the future. John Holman could be one of those captains, of course, like I said, in his first year. I had a chance to talk to him moments ago. Ask him, hey, what are your expectations? Just keep moving on. And you know, I asked him, hey, how do you feel you've performed? And he definitely understood. He was shaky at first. Everyone saw it. The nerves were coming. His first match, he actually sat in the bathroom for over an hour, sick to his stomach, and the nerves really got to him. I remember I used to wrestle back in elementary school. I was nervous then. I could only imagine being a wrestler now when the matches really do count. But overall, he's definitely grown. His endurance has definitely improved. Overall, Holman and company trying to have a successful invitational, trying to come on top. They'll take on Kalkaska here just moments away. They're warming up and stretching out right now. I'm Brendan Morris. So once again, thank you for watching. And the Mansalona wrestlers for today, Brianna Benham will be wrestling at her actual weight of 104. Ian Somerville weighing in at 111. Yeah, that's Somerville's first time making weight this season. Angel Schauer coming in at 120. Joseph Johnston coming at 126. Hunter Johnson at 131. Harris Morgan running out 137 for the lightweights. And now Jacob Henry wrestling at that 141 spot. Doesn't look like a very big kid, but he's got a little height on him. Should add some weight. Colin Ritchie Blue, Mansalona's beloved, 146. Isaiah Grosser, 150. Andrew Nygren weighing in at 156. Hayden Wagonschutz weighing at 148, and Nate Johnson at 150. Andrew Anderson weighing at 209 to start the big guys, and John Holman rounding it off at 242. Those are eligible wrestlers today. Of course, it will depend on their matches against Kalkaska, of who will be able to actually wrestle. The tough part about facing other teams, if your weight doesn't match up to theirs, you oftentimes have to forfeit. If they've got a guy at a 140 and you don't have a 140 guy, well, you just gave up points. And a lot of times that's how they're unable to get the team wins when they don't have the amount of wrestlers they really want or need. So Massillon is still warming up. Kalkaska getting ready, coming off their win against Forest Area. And the other mat, we have Lake City and Boynton City going head-to-head. Lake City and Massillon will take on each other in the third round. We'll only cover Kalkaska and Lake City due to the times of this meet. This meet definitely can last a very long time. And unfortunately, some of our equipment is needed for other school programs and clubs like robotics. There's a robotics competition my fellow partners are on my broadcasting team. Need to use some of this valuable equipment for their robot and their competition. But we will cover as much Massillona action as we can. So once again, thanks for tuning in. I'm Brendan Morse. Stay tuned for the matchup between the Massillona Ironmen and the Kalkaska Blazers. Thank you. Hello, welcome back to Massillona Broadcasting, moments away from Massillona-Kalkaska matchup. I'm Brendan Morse. Wrestling first for the Ironmen, Jacob Henry at 141. As for Kalkaska, that's going to be Cody Ishro. His actual weight is 142. So this is the 145 weight class. Jacob Henry and Cody Ishro. Henry trying to get things started for the Ironman. Ishro locks up Henry. Trying to use each other's momentum to bring one of them down. Got a little stalemate going on right now. One of them trying to get a move on the other. Now Israel looking for the takedown. Henry trying to fight it, don't want to go on the back. And 2 points there for Israel. So Israel is still working on Henry. Henry trying to fight his way out of it. Just trying to get that right leg free. Ishro trying to put that shoulder down, break up 45 degree angle. Henry doing a fantastic job of fighting his way out of it. But it's got to stop letting Israel get a hold of him. He's just picking up easy points. Easy takedown points. Israel with the left arm now. Trying to get that shoulder down. Here's a count. And a pin. Jacob Henry pin in the 11th second of the first period. Kalkaska strikes first blood. And Henry goes down. Great job by Ice Road there. And Henry, a hard-fought match. So, Colin Richie Belew up next. All eyes will be on him. Picked up his 100th win earlier this year. Has won plenty more and will win plenty more to come. Kellen Ritchie with it. That takedown. Trying to flip him over on the back. Has the right arm. Working on that shoulder. Easily handled by Ritchie. Colin has been fundraising for a trip to Australia to wrestle with some fantastic wrestlers down under. Definitely a great accomplishment there by the senior. Richie still working on that shoulder, trying to get him over to his back. Just earning the points. Colin Richie 6-0. Colin Richie with the shoulder and the pin. Didn't take long, 30 seconds remaining in the period, and he gets it with the pin. Add it to the win column, my friend. Colin Richie does it again, almost automatic there on the mat. So tied up, six apiece now as a team. And wrestling is really the ultimate team individual sport. Individual team sport. You're wrestling all on your own. It's just you and your opponent out there on the mat. Three tough rounds. All on your shoulders. But in the end, your performance affects how your team does. If you're able to pick up the wins when you need it, your team definitely succeeds. So now, Grozer, Isaiah Grozer, in a 152 weight class, taking on Brendan Legaski or Trent Siding. Grozer gets taken down. Legaski gets the points. Grozer, another young gun on this Barcelona team. Big expectations for him. Grozer gets a point for getting back up, putting on a fight. Grozer working on the leg, looking for the takedown. Trying to get away from the out of bounds. Grozer with the takedown. Yeah. Blazers trying to fight this arm wrestler off. Definitely has the size to keep him here. But just trying to get that half Nelson in there. Turn that shoulder over and start working on the pin. 33 seconds remaining in the first period. Grosser does like to go into the later rounds, as do a few other wrestlers. You know, Colton Fredrickson likes to take it easy the first two rounds, tire out his opponent, and then strike blood in the third round. But not actual blood, because you don't want blood time here. 5 seconds and counting. Grosser on top. And that does it for the first period. 6-2 in favor of Grosser. And he wants to go neutral. Kalkaska gets the decision and will go down. Not the match decision. Grosser. Still trying to lock the arm. Get that Nelson in there. Trent sighting. Trying to fight off Grosser. But so far, Grosser's been the one to capitalize. And so far has controlled this match. Leads in points so far. Still 2-5. Grosser pushes him out of bounds, so some advice from Coach Crothers. And a full Nelson there, that's a new illegal move. That's 1 point for the Blazers. That was a technical violation. It's the warning there. Grosser looking to get some near fall in. Really not able to budge that shoulder. Could he get it here? Grosser working. What a match there by the young Isaiah Grosser, picking up the pin in the 5th second, just 5 seconds remaining in the second period. Grosser gets the win, and the Ironmen now take the team lead. So up next for the Ironmen, Nate Johnson wrestling at 160. So Lake City and Boyne City are done. Now it's going to be Lake City and Forestaria. Nate Johnson gets taken down. Nate, once again, another young guy on this team. Freshman Nate with the reversal, though. There we go. You gotta be careful, don't go out of bounds. Nate has a hold of that right arm. Both wrestlers back to neutral and back to the takedown. There's Nate Johnson. Has the half Nelson. Looking for that turnover. Has the back. And then Nate Chance starts. Working on the shoulder. And he gets it. Some solid wrestling going on right here. Back-to-back pins by Grozer and Nate Johnson. And the W there by the Ironman. And a brace there. Two good wrestlers going at it. Good job by the rookie Nate Johnson to get another Ironman win. So, Youngblood Andrew Nygren, well, really shouldn't say young. He's been in this sport all of his life, now a junior. Still the youngest of the three Nygren brothers. He's got an older brother in college and an older brother standing right to his right coaching him. So it's always nice to have a wrestling background and have brothers to teach you. And now his oldest, Tevin, able to give back to the Ironman faithful after his great season of wrestling. He really had one of the greatest teams Manson Malone could ever ask for during his wrestling season himself. Tristan Waters, Keegan Richardson, as well as other wrestlers like Derek Munchback. There's just so many great wrestlers in the early to mid 2000, 2010, and 2014 were two big seasons for the Ironman. So, Nygren with it. Nygren's weight 156. Back to neutral now. And stalemate here. Trying to use some momentum. Nygren working on the takedown. It's the 2 points there. Earning them. Blazers trying to get out of it. Just stalling. Still got a minute in that first period, so he's got to stall for a long time or work to get up and work on a reversal against Nygren. Nygren's got that left arm. Has him tied up, working on the shoulder. And Nygren can't finish it off. Nygren gets taken down. And the reversal credited to the Blazers. Nygren trying to get out of it. Break out of that stance and back down goes Nygren. This Blazer wrestler a little bit larger, but they're near the same weight class. So Nygren credited with the reversal. Now 5 seconds and counting. Nygren has the lead in points. 6 points, and that ends the first period. Nygren up 6-3. Could potentially have some blood time. So, they'll clean up Niagara New real quick. I'm Brendan Morris. We'll be right back. Hello, welcome back. So Matt Ellis for the Blazers working on Nygren. Some difficulties with the clock. Andrew Nygren, Matt Ellis. Ellis working on a takedown. Nygren trying to get out of it. Now I got a big body on him. What a play there. What a move there by Nygren. Working on that pin. And a lot of yelling from the sidelines. Trying to direct him. Has that back leg. All eyes on this match right now. Nygren still working on the shoulder. Just needs a little bit more to break that 45 degree angle. Try and get that pin. He doesn't want points, he wants the pin. 5 seconds left. And it is time. Nygren credited with 3 points there. So now, Nygren with 14, Ellis with 11. Now into the final period of regulation. Take down there by Nygren as Ellis locked up. Just stalling right now. But if you're Matt Ellis for the Blazers, you're trying to work on points. And right now, Nygren could potentially be the one just going for the pin. He's got the lead in points. So really, he could be content staying here. Because either way, he gets the pin, he wins. Or if it stays like this, wins in points by decision. Nygren trying to keep Ellis down, but Ellis using those strong legs to get back up. But now back on his back. And a pin. Nygren wasn't letting him get away this time. And a win there by the junior. Great job there. to pick up another Iron Mowen in the 48th second of the third period. Up next, we have Andrew Anderson, other known as AJ, wrestling in the 215 class. He'll be wrestling. Eddie Davidson. And Joe Smith out there. Sorry. Not Joe Smith. Correction. Eddie Davidson now up against Anderson. Anderson and Davis. Eddie Davis for the Blazers. Checking in. The big men start their wrestling. Anderson, Davidson up. And Davidson already coming out aggressively. He just looks like a solid wrestler. And Andrew Anderson taken down and pinned within the first few seconds. 1:33 remained in the first period, and Anderson taken down. A great match by Davidson. Almost saw that one coming. A solid wrestler. And now the big man John Holman wrestling in the 285 weight class. Joe Smith, Sean Holman, John Holman, Joe Smith going at it, have each other locked up. So once again, thank you for watching. I'm Brendan Morris. You can watch all live coverage of Mansalona sports, from girls and boys basketball to wrestling. We have our first wrestling invitational in a few weeks. We've had a tri meet earlier this season. We've been able to get a few in, but it's always tough doing wrestling. It's just the nature of the sport, and they travel a lot, not a whole lot of home meets, but a lot more than in the past. So now Holman working on Smith. Holman's picked up two. Smith credited with a reversal. And now Holman on his back trying to get a win. Trying to get away. Joe Smith, very experienced wrestler here, working on that shoulder. Holman trying to sprawl out of it. It's something. Just a little bit more. Holman trying to go towards his bench. Roll that right shoulder onto his stomach. Joe Smith just in pain. Trying so hard. And Holman with the reversal. And Smith saved by the bell. My goodness. Holman got it right at the end. And then Smith couldn't hold him off, couldn't end it, but was able to hold him off in the first period. Smith exhausted after that first one. And I'm sure Holman is, but he's definitely worked on his endurance and his ability. And definitely solid season for him, and the expectations aren't too high, but still, they will be very high next year. Expectations never are really too high in the first year, but then again, you got a guy like Holman has tremendous size. There are definitely expectations, just not going to be disappointed if he doesn't have all the wins in the world. Still definitely gaining some experience, and he'll have next year. Holman, taken down by Smith. Trying to roll, was in this situation earlier. Smith, still working on Holman. Points there for Smith. Takes the lead in points. And a reversal there by Holman. Has Joe Smith on his back. And gets the pin. And he's excited about that one. Aren't we all? What a job there by John Holman. First year wrestler gets the win off the pin. Joe Smith, great match. Tried so hard there. That's why this sport is the hardest. And we may have some blood on the mat. So up next, Brianna Benham. Wrestling in the 103 weight class. And Easton Heiss. In the 103, Ethan Heiss, Brianna Benham. Up next, Ironman 30-18 team total. Just about three wrestlers left. Blazers still have a chance to win it as a team, but they're gonna need some solid wins here. The Ironman done a fantastic job so far. Putting together some solid pins. Grosser, Ballou, Holman. So far, being very physical. Andrew Nygren also putting together a great match. Benham working on Heiss. Two points there for the reversal by Benham. Brianna still on top. Heiss trying to roll out of it. Get her back to neutral. Benham now on her back. Heiss, solid move with the reversal. Benham rolls on over. And what a move by Benham. Taking control of Heiss. Her mom watching in the stands, cheering her on. Benham trying to avoid that pin. 5 seconds. Now 3-2. And that does it for the first period. So now in this second, 4-11, Heist with a solid lead over Benham. Benham might need to get the pin here soon. Heist is racking up all the points. Over on the other map, Warriors taking on Lake City Trojans. Right now, Trojans dominating 36-12 as a team. Back on over the Mansalona. Benham still working against Heist. Stalemate right now, neither one really a solid advantage, but Heist has it in points. And the count begins. Broke that 45-degree angle, the pin. Brianna Benham, solid match, but taken down. 103 remaining in the second period. So some of the welterweights, these smaller guys, time for them to wrestle. Ian Somerville making weight, first time this season, 112. Not the first time this season, first home match this season for him. David Morgan taking on Ian Somerville. Somerville in his rookie year, freshman. First home match for the freshman. Family with phones out recording. Definitely a young kid, has a lot to learn and grow. If he can keep his grades up and focus on wrestling and really learn the style of it, he could be a potentially great wrestler, but taken down there. Making some rookie mistakes. Letting Blazer control him. So Morgan, no relation to Aris Morgan. And Somerville trying to pick up some points. Has the right leg of Morgan on his back now. Somerville trying to get out of it. David Morgan working on Somerville, looking for the pin. And he gets it. In the 35 seconds. In the first period, David Morgan with the W. Now Angel Schauer in the 119 weight class. Checking on Gabrielle Douglas. Rare occasion two ladies actually get to wrestle. A lot of times it's guy versus girl. Not always a whole lot of girl wrestlers, but definitely starting to show up. Definitely more respected in the sport and proving their strength and ability. Angel Schauer, definitely a solid wrestler. Showers with the reversal. Takedown on Douglas. So it's a nail biter in team points now. 30-30. It's all tied up team-wise. This is turning out to be a very, very good matchup. Blazers and Ironman, they'll meet all season. They've met before. Angel Showers needs a win here. Looking for the pin. They could use it. Showers trying to come in clutch, working on the shoulder. Douglas not going to give it to her. There we go. Pin. And she gets it. Heck of a match there by Angel Showers. 51 seconds remaining in the first period. Good match there by Gabby Douglas for the Blazers. So Ironman retake the team points. Now Joey Johnston on the mat. Resting at the 125 weight. Even sim check for the Blazers. Johnson sim check. Johnson, one of those guys you can definitely see being an overall solid wrestler. Still a young guy though, just a freshman. Plenty of years to grow. Hasn't always been able to wrestle due to grades or making weight. They'll definitely need him now. What a move. Johnson going for it right away. Working on the pin, has that right shoulder. Has the left one working on the right. Johnston on the tippy toes. Trying to drive. Shimchek not gonna give it to him easily. And the pin. Johnston, what a great job there. 56 seconds remaining. Gets it done. So now 42-30 in team points. And Hunter Johnston in the 130 weight class. And he gets it there. The forfeit there. Johnston getting the decision, so that's a few more points, 48-30 now. And Eris Morgan up. And another void. Morgan. Solid all around wrestler. Definitely should be a hard match here. Oh, man. That was a tough one for Morgan, but he got it done. Hey, easy job for Calcasters. Don't have to worry about Morgan beating him in the pin. So that ends it. Massalona dominating Kelkaska, 54-30, final score for the team. Lots of great performances. Grosser, Holman, Ballou, Nygren, all solid pins. Johnston pitching in as well. All around great performance. Angel Showers doing good. So overall, solid team performance, impressive Invitational turnout for the Ironman. They'll take on Lake City up next. So once again, thank you for watching. I'm Brendan Morris. Make sure to tune in for the matchup between Mansalona and Lake City. That will be our final live matchup. And then the Ironmen will wrestle Boyne City afterwards. And then Forestaria looking for wins over Forestaria and the team. Got a win over Kalkaska, so they just need two more to sweep it. Or at least one of the Lake City-Boyne City matchup to take the Invitational. So once again, thank you for watching. I'm Brandon Moore. Stay tuned. Hello, welcome back to Mancelona Broadcasting as the Mancelona Captains and Lake City Captains meeting at center of the mat. Moments away from the start of the third round. Five rounds in this Mancelona Invitational. In this third round, Mancelona will face Lake City. Boyne City and Forest Area face off, and Kalkaska gets to take a break. In the fourth round, Mancelona takes on Boyne City, while Kalkaska takes on Lake City. And then in the fifth round, Mancelona and Forest Area, and Boyne City and Kalkaska, Lake City will take a break. After this round, however, we'll have a lunch break, and we will be done here with our filming of today's Invitational. So Colin Richie Ballou gets things started with a void, so puts team points on first. Last time he wrestled the guy for Inland, for Lake City, he injured him, so now he's got no one to wrestle. He's not so happy about that, but hey, easy team points there. And yet another void. So a few voids to start things out. That was Nate Johnson. So Lake City defeated Forest Area, but then again, Forest Area only has a few wrestlers. Mancelona actually sent one of their wrestlers over to help out Forest Area, Hayden Wagonchutes, getting some time on a smaller team. So Isaiah Grosser taking on Lake City in the 152 class. So we don't have a weight for 152. I'm going to guess it's John Larkin in the 160 weight class. So we're going to go with Larkin and Grosser. Grosser working on Larkin. Larkin definitely a experienced wrestler. Grosser, just a young freshman. But a freshman with that kind of size makes you smile if you're Coach Crothers. Isaiah on his stomach trying to fight off Larkin. Larkin's not an easy guy to get away from. Larkin working on the Nelson. He has one. He's got to be careful on his move there and how he bends Grosser's arm. Isaiah Grosser out of bounds, so he'll go down. Forty seconds remaining in the match. Back to neutral as Grosser goes for the takedown. Grosser gets back up. Almost out of bounds again. Time ticking down. 10 seconds and counting. Out of bounds. 2 points there by Larkin. Grosser being a little physical. 3-4 in favor of Larkin. Boyne City winning the team battle on the other mat. Mancelona 12-0 right now after two voids. Grosser down. Out of bounds, back up to neutral. Roser working on the takedown, 4-4 now. Out of bounds. 1:27 now in the second period. Back up top, neutral. Larkin and Grosser going at it. Grosser trying to get Larkin on the shoulder. Larkin on the stomach. Seconds now. Grosser doing work, not really giving Larkin any room. You got to be very impressed with how Grosser's performing so far. Young guy knows how to wrestle. Really just a stalemate right now. Larkin could be just stalling to get out of the match. Grosser's got the point, 6-4. 20 seconds now. Larkin able to get back up to neutral. Out of bounds though. Larkin a little tired as his headgear falls off. Larkin taken down by Grosser. Man, this kid very impressive so far. Isaiah Grosser got a solid pin in the first match against Kalkaska. Working hard here against Larkin. 6-4, 10 seconds now. But Larkin gets up. And that'll do it for the second period. 6-5, Larkin gets a point. So now neutral. Grosser leads by one going into the final round. This one to decide who wants it most. Shroud always called the heart round. Who's got the most heart to gut it out? Grosser. What a reversal there by Grosser. 2 points. Give it to him. Coach is yelling. And a roll the other way. Grossman going the wrong way. It's going to be out of bounds. No confusion on that point score, but both wrestlers got a reversal. So now 8-7, Grosser still 1 point lead. Grosser gets Larkin. There's the pinch in. Come on. Grosser. Larkin getting out of it. Now Larkin on Grosser looking for the pin. Back and forth. 38 seconds into third. All tied up, 10-10. Grosser trying to get out of it. Larkin could have a pin here. Twenty-two seconds and counting. Grosser's got a turn over to his right. Stalemate so far. Larkin just looking for the shoulder. Grossman's got two and the pin. Wow. 10 seconds remaining. Larkin pins Grossman or Grosser to take the match. Grosser was leading in points too. Solid match. What an exciting match, too. But great performance by the young wrestler. Cannot be upset at all about that one. Wrestled very hard. So now Lake City on the board. 12-6 is the score. Be sure to watch all live coverage of Mansalona sports from girls and boys basketball to wrestling. We'll give you the coverage. This will be the last match recover for the Ironmen, and then they'll go to lunch break and we'll be out of here. They still have Boyne City and Forest Air to take on. Last night, girls basketball took on Central Lake JV, lost, but varsity able to pick up a big win, won by about 20. So Andrew Nygren coming in the 160 class. So Andrew Nygren will just take on Andrew Brown. So Andrew versus Andrew. Nygren so far credited with the takedown. Nygren looking for the pin as Brown all tied up. Could get it early. Brown fighting, working on both shoulders. Pin! Hey, Andrew Nygren, back-to-back pins for the junior. And a round of applause there for him. So 189 now. And a void there for the Trojans. Now in the 215, Kevin Maxwell, and they're gonna send out Andrew Anderson. So 18-12 team points. Anderson. Stalemate so far, both trying to use the momentum, looking for a takedown. Andrew Anderson taken down. Maxwell. Anderson gets a point, gets back up, got to go right at him. Can't waste any time. Has the left leg, needs to get a takedown. Maxwell just pushing the head down. Anderson needs to just lunge forward. Get that leg sweep. But Maxwell sprawling away. Good job by Maxwell to keep him at bay. So wrestling is definitely one of the hardest sports for sure. It takes so much out of your body. 2 tough minutes every period, 3 periods. And you almost never wrestle someone your exact weight. You have a certain weight class you have to make. But you almost always wrestle someone a little heavier than you, or maybe a little smaller, a little taller or wider. I definitely know I would not be cut out for wrestling. I've tried it in the past and never was too good at it. I don't know, just was never the biggest, strongest, or fastest. And you kind of need all of those three things in wrestling. Really in every sport, but hey, that's why I'm the one with the headset and not on the court or on the mat. 150 in the second period. 1-4, Maxwell leading. And pin Maxwell. Win over Anderson. That should tie it up. Good win there by Maxwell in Lake City. So now 18 apiece. So I'm Brendan Moore. Stay tuned. John Holman up right after. Hello, I'm Brendan Morris. Welcome back. My apologies. Thomas Miller was the winner last round, not Maxwell. Gavin Maxwell is now very similar weight classes. And just their last names, both M's. Looked at the roster real quick, looked away, and I had the wrong name. So that's my bad. So this is Maxwell taking on Holman. Miller was the one who took down Anderson last match. It's all 18 apiece right here, Lake City, Mansalona, in this grudge match. John Holman won by pin in his last match. Has his brother, father, and uncle watching. Out of bounds. Still neutral, Holman trying to work on Maxwell. There we go, Holman gets him on his knees. Trying to work on that left leg. Possibly get him in a cradle. Holman with 2 points, 26 seconds remaining. 2 seconds, and that does it for the first period. So a slow start to the first period, not much going on. Home and up 2-0. They're going to go neutral. So back at it. Homan sprawling out. And violation there. Can't grab the ankles and move them like that. So that's a warning there. Homan taken out by Maxwell. Maxwell has a hold of the leg. Homan trying to break out of it. Two points for the reversal for Homan. Homan manhandling him right now. Maxwell trying to fight out of it. Hey, there goes Homan. Look for the pin. And there goes the chant. Homan's still working on Maxwell. Maxwell doing everything he can. He's got to hold on for 50 seconds. And the pin! What a job there by Homan. Two wins now for the big man. Getting the hang of things. He gets a win there, now 24-18. Team score, Brianna Benham. Up next, in the 103 weight class, taking on Tasha Anderson. Benham lost the last match, trying to pick up a win here. Benham working on Anderson. Brianna Benham trying to get the pin. Oh, what a great move. Anderson getting out of it. But Benham still has her. And a pin. Way to go by Benham with a minute remaining in the first period. Anderson. Tough loss there. And Benham picks up the W. Ian Somerville up next. It'll be a void. So Tasha Anderson was not happy at all with her performance. Coach trying to calm her down. Ian Somerville. He'll get a void. So I have to work much harder there. So that's points racking up for Mansalona. Trying to get another team win. They definitely would love to be the winners of their own home invitational. So far, went over Kalkaska. And right now, they're handling Lake City pretty well. Boynton City, really that key matchup between the two. Angel Shower here, 119 with Connor Bagerman. Be a tough matchup for Angel showers and Fagerman. Hey! Already working, but out of bounds. Angel Shower working on Fagerman. Showers on top. 2 points for the reversal. Get Fagerman on his back. Fagerman trying to get back up. Fagerman just stalling. And Showers taking out now Fagerman with the reversal. Showers back up now. She gets credited with the reversal. Back and forth. 4-2, Showers leads. Wants the pin. 30 seconds remaining in the period. Angel Showers with the pin against Fagerman. Great job there. Angel Showers with the win. 42-18, team score. So Joey Johnston in the 125 matchup with Zach Stockman. Joey Johnston working on Stockman. Zach Stockman trying to get back up. What a takedown there by Johnston. The count. Working on the shoulder. 1 minute remaining in the period. Not quite there. Really just inches away. Stockman holding him off. Needs to hold on for 40 more seconds. Stockman now has Johnston with the legs. And a pin. Johnston all the way. Three pins in a row from Mancelona. Bannon with a pin, Showers with a pin, and Johnston with a pin. And so far, Mancelona dominating Lake City 48-18 now. And it definitely kills having all those voids. And I don't think there'll be too many more matches for Lake City, so Ironman will most likely take this team matchup. But up next is Hunter Johnston. And Tony Youngs. Hunter Johnston in his first match today. Hunter Johnston working on the pin. Johnston has Youngs on his back. Youngs working to get out of it. Harris Morgan should be wrestling soon, so make sure to watch that. The reversal, Stockman, or sorry, Youngs. And out of play, 48-18 team score, 5-2. Individual score, Hunter Johnston leading with 18 seconds in the period. Still in the first. Hunter Johnston trying to fight off Young. And that does it for the first period. So I'm Brendan Moore. Stay tuned for the next period right after this. Johnston leads 5-2. Hello, welcome back. I'm Brandon Morris. Hunter Johnston and Young going at it. Johnston leads in points, but Young's not going to make it easy. Definitely not going down without a fight. Mancelona leads 48-18 in team points. Hunter's got to do something to stalemate right now. Really not much action going on. Young's trying to get Hunter's right arm behind him. Get some half Nelson or something, trying to get on his back. Hunter Johnson's just got to try and get back up and start over. Right now, Young's just got him. It's tied 5-5 now. Thank you. Johnson with the reversal. Justin now has Youngs on his back. Justin working on Youngs. And no more time. That does it for the second period. So some clarification by the referee for points. So 10-7, Hunter Johnson in the lead, 48-18. Up next, Aris Morgan should be in action. That'll be a great matchup. Aris Morgan wrestling in the 135 will face Devin Davis. Aris Morgan trying to pick up some solid wins, so Hunter Johnston will go neutral. So 1:45, just 15 seconds gone in the third, final round of regulation. We'll be done with the live coverage of this Mansell Invitational after this matchup between the Lake City Trojans and the Mansell Ironmen. Ironmen will have two more rounds between Boyne City and Forest Area. They'll beat Forest Area team-wise. That'll be more of an individual matchup just due to Forest Area's low numbers. But Boyne City for sure should be a strong matchup, so if Mansell can win it here, they could potentially win the whole thing and be okay. They'd be okay with a loss against Boyne City. Then again, Boyne City taking out Forest Area. Lake City actually beat Boyne City. So if Mansell could beat Lake City, it wouldn't be too bad. It would almost automatically put the Ironmen at the top, but they definitely want to sweep them. So Johnston still in the lead by 1 point, 10-9, 40 seconds left. And counting in the third, Stillman Johnson just trying to hold on, 30 seconds now. Seconds, can Johnson hold on? 10-9. He's just got to hold on. 5 more seconds. 3 more seconds. 1, and it's all over. Johnston hangs on to win it. Hunter Johnston picks up the win by decision. There he goes, 10-9. In the third round. And Johnston wins that one, puts his team up 54-18. They'll walk away with a team victory. Too large of a lead now, but Trojans can definitely pick up a few individual wins. But hey, this one, but as tough as it gets, Aris Morgan take on Devin Davis. Devin Davis, clearly the underdog. Aris Morgan, so good. But Davis, do not underestimate him. Morgan with the takedown, 2 points. And he's just pulling him back. He wants him. Morgan just manhandling Davis. If you're Davis, you're just trying to fend him off. Morgan! Wow, with the cradle. Davis trying to get out of it. Morgan going for the pin. And way to go by Davis to get out of it. But Morgan still picking up the points. 5-0 already. Correction on the team total points, 51-18 is the score, not 54. And the pin, Morgan destroys Davis. Devin Davis a little slow to get up. He's hurting. Harris Morgan, fantastic job off the pin, almost automatic. This guy's so dangerous on the mat. And a win there. So we're almost to the end, 57-18. This is the 140 weight class matchup. Dustin Jackson for Lake City and Jacob Henry for Mancelona. And that should end it for today's matchup between these two teams. So once again, thank you for tuning in. I'm Brendan Morris. Watch all live coverage of Mancelona sports, from girls and boys basketball to wrestling. You can rewatch last night's matchup between Central Lake and Mancelona. So some scheduling conflicts could be ahead of us. We will do our best to cover both boys and girls varsity and JV basketball. However, my camera crew might not be able to be available, which kind of stinks. Might not be available for some girls' JV games. So might not be covering the JV games for sure, varsity games, but due to their schooling and schedule after school, that 5 o'clock and 6 o'clock range, they're still busy. But we will for sure continue doing varsity and hopefully some JV guys, because they're still undefeated on the season. Jacob Henry going for the pin. Jacob Henry with the pin. He's pumped. Finishing it off fantastically. That ends it. Mancelona with a dominating 63-18 team win. Jacob Henry to finish it off, to put the stamp of approval on it. Mancelona dominating win. Solid performances really all around. So many pins. Blue not able to wrestle. It was Colin Richie Blue. Didn't have a match. Harris Morgan did a fantastic job. Brianna Benham. Jonathan Holman. Grosser had a very competitive match. Angel Showers won big. So overall, fantastic. Fantastic put together. And that will do it for us. Thank you for watching our live coverage of Mancelona Wrestling here at our Invitational. They'll go into their lunch break and then come back. Mancelona takes on Boyne City. So once again, I'm your host, Brendan Morse. Thank you for watching. Good night. Tune in next week for some more Mancelona sports action.